नमस्ते जीविन, आई जीविन शोभा कुमारी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स इंस्टीट्यूट जयपुर। टुडे आई डिलीवर लेक्चर ऑन दिस टॉपिक पैकेज ऑफ प्रैक्टिसेस सपोर्ट एंड ग्रो। कॉटन इंट्रोडक्शन। कॉटन इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इंपोर्टेंट फाइबर एंड कैश क्रॉप ऑफ द इंडिया and play a dominant role in the industrial and agriculture economy of the country. It provides the basic new material cotton fiber to cotton textile industry. Cotton in India provides direct livelihood to 6 million farmers, and about 40 to 50 million people are employed in the cotton trade and its processing. In India, there are 10 major cotton growing states, which are divided in three zones: North Zone, Central Zone, and South Zone. North Zone consists of the Punjab, Haryana, and Rajasthan. Central Zone includes Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, and Gujarat. South Zone comprises Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. Besides this, 10 state cotton cultivation has gained momentum in the eastern state of Odisha. Cotton is also cultivated in small area of non-traditional state such as UP, West Bengal, and Tripura. Cultivated species of cotton. There are four cultivated species of cotton: Gossypium arboreum, Gossypium herbaceum, Gossypium hirsutum, Gossypium barbadens. The first two species are deployed to 26 are native to all world. They are also known as Asiatic cotton because they are grown in Asia. Firstly, which one species? Gossypium arboreum or Gossypium herbaceum is also known as all world cotton, Asiatic cotton. The last two species are tetraploid. Which one? Gossypium hirsutum, Gossypium barbadens are the tetraploid. 2 and 52, and also referred to as a new world cotton. New world cotton. Gossypium hirsutum is also known as American cotton or upland cotton, and Gossypium barbadens as Egyptian cotton or sea Iceland cotton or Peruvian cotton or Tungbish cotton or quality cotton. These are the synonyms name of the Gossypium barbadens. Gossypium hirsutum is the predominant species, which alone contribute about 90% to the global production. Perhaps India is the only country in the world where all the four cultivated species are grown on commercial scale. Seed rate and spacing of cotton. Cotton is typically planted in wider 38 or 40 inches row. However, narrower row spacing may provide yield benefit under ideal growing condition. When planting in 30-inch 2:1 skip row, the plant population within each row must be increased to fill for the skip row. Climate and soil requirement. Cotton is semi-xerophytic plants, is grown in tropical, subtropical condition. A minimum temperature of 15 degrees Celsius is required for better germination at field condition. The optimum temperature for vegetative growth is 21 to 27 degrees Celsius. It can tolerate temperatures to extend 43 degrees Celsius, but temperature below 21 degrees Celsius is detrimental to the growth. A warm day of cool night with large diurnal variation during the period of the fruiting are the conducive to good bulb fiber development. Cotton is grown on a variety of soil ranging from the well-drained deep alluvial soil in the north to black clay soil of varying depth in the central region and in a black and mixed black and red soil in the south zone. Cotton is semi-tolerant to salinity and sensitive to waterlogging and thus prefer well-drained soil. Crop season. The sowing season of the cotton varies considerably from the tract to the tract. It generally early April to May in northern India and is delayed as well proceeds to down south monsoon. best in the southern zone. Cotton is a kharif crop in the major part of the country, vice Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan, UP, MP, Gujarat, Maharashtra, and parts of Andhra and Karnataka. In this area, the irrigated crop is sown from March to May, and the rain-fed crop in June to July with the commencement of the monsoon. In parts of the Karnataka and Andhra, the desi cotton is usually sown in August to September. In addition, summer sowing in the Tamil Nadu are done during Feb to March. The sowing of cotton in the rice fallow of the Andhra and Tamil Nadu extend from the second half of the December to the middle. Preparation of land. How to prepare for land for cultivation of cotton? The time available for the land preparation following the harvest of the wheat is limited in the north zone. Pre-sowing irrigation is undertaken after the harvest of wheat. The land is worked upon the with tractor-drawn implements, then leveled and planked before preparing ridge upon which sowing is done. In central and southern zone of India, where the cotton is rain-fed crop, deep plowing is recommended to the destroying the perennial weeds once in 4 years. The field is prepared by the repeated harrowing with the blade harrow prior to onset of pre-monsoonal. Sowing is undertaken on ridge and furrow in dry land for moisture conservation and in weed management. Method of sowing. Cotton is sown using tractor or bullock drawn seed drill or by the dibbling. Head dibbling of seed at a recommended spacing is commonly practiced in rain-fed area. Particularly for the hybrids, this system ensures proper plant stand, uniform geometry, and also have seeds. This is now main system of sowing of BT hybrids. Now, cotton cultivation on ridges across the slopes consume more water and reduce soil erosion and improve yield. Irrigation scheduling for the cotton crop. Depending upon the climate and crop growing periods, cotton needs 700 to 1200 mm water to meet its maximum water requirement. What is water requirement? Water need throughout the life cycle of the crop. Total amount of water need is required for the complete the life cycle of crop. It is known as a water requirement. The water requirement is low during the first 60 to 70 days after sowing and highest during the flowering and the bowl development. Cotton is a commonly flood irrigated, although irrigation by the furrow is alternate furrows method is more effective and water saving. Drip irrigation is becoming popular, particularly in the hybrids for the central southern zone. Cotton needs to be irrigated at 50 to 70% depletion of available soil moisture. On a sandy soil of northern zone, 3 to 5 irrigation are commonly given. Intercultivation and weed control. Intercultivation practices are done after the sowing of crop in standing crop. Intercultivation is done fairly regularly by either blade harrow with a three-tined hoe and desi plow. In the crop sown by the broadcasting, one or two hand hoeings are given to remove weeds. Unwanted plants are the unwanted plants growing out of place, out of time, are known as weed. Intercultivation not only checks the growth of weeds, but also lead to better soil aeration and soil moisture conservation. Weed compete with cotton crop for nutrient, light, moisture. Cotton is susceptible to weed competition from the sowing to about 70 days when the canopy covers the entire space. Cotton yield are reduced by the 50 to 85% if weed growth is unchecked. Flucloridine and pendimethalin at the rate 1 kg active ingredient per hectare as pre-plant incorporation with the one hand winding and crosswise hoeing has been recommended for satisfactory weed control. What is thinning? The thinning of the cotton crop is a special feature of the irrigated crop sown in peninsular India and in parts of southern Gujarat. Thinning, undesirable plant, infested disease plant are removed. And this is a practice which is known as thinning practices. Thinning is desirable for 37 maintaining the optimum population of plant to obtain a high yield. During thinning, the vigorous seedling are returned, a weak seedling and off types are removed. Fertilizer dose and method of application: fertilizer NPK 40-20-20, 50-25-25 ratio, 80-40-44. For depend on the varieties. For hybrid 100-50-50, 160-80-80. These are the ratio of NPK. Method of fertilizer application: nitrogen in three splits, air sowing, squaring, and peak flowering stage. Nitrogen dose is applied in a split formation. Total amount of nitrogen fertilizer divided in three. First are applied on sowing time as a basin. Second one on squaring time, and third one is at the time of flowering stage. Phosphorus and potassium according to soil test. Application of 2% urea or DAP at flowering, and early bulb development. Biofertilizer, seed treatment with the Azotobacter is beneficial. Thank you guys. If you have any doubt regarding this session, please write in comment box.